Okay, I think the first tip that I can give is to look at your earning capacity and find out whether or not buying a property will make a minor or a major revision of your budgeting process. A lot of times, buyers think that they can afford to buy a property, which in the most likelihood they can. Okay, but what happens after they bought a property is what is now the challenge or the happy consequence of being a homeowner. Now, property is one of very few things in the Philippines that you can buy on a long-term basis. Therefore, we must always have the correct mindset in buying property. I've always said that because it cannot be denied that the Philippine economy has grown in the past 10 or 15 years, so that ordinary working class Filipinos already have more disposable income today. And the question really is what you do with your disposable income. You can buy it on consumption, or you can now pool your consumption expenses together and buy real estate property, which is number one, could be a primary shelter for you, but also a vehicle by which you can attain financial freedom when the property prices appreciate over time. Therefore, what is important now for me to understand is you've got to accept a certain minimum change in your lifestyle and spending habits. And once you have accepted that, then paying a monthly amortization for a property becomes all the more easy.
For those who are choosing between condominium or house, what is your opinion on that?
Well, it depends on your need, actually. People who are very mobile and would like to stay inside the city would opt for condominiums. The advantage of a condominium for me is that it is a lock and leave type of a property. In other words, you don't need to worry about your security. You don't need to worry about many other things that you would, like making sure that there are repairs in the house and lot, making sure that there's somebody always there because of security issues. But if you have a family and you'd like the family to actually have a garden or a yard, or you'd like to actually move residents to a bigger place, then buying a house and lot allows you to actually do that, expand as your income actually expands over time. So it depends on your objectives. In many cities around the world, people actually move as many as 10 times during their lifetime. And so for me, what is also important in choosing whether it's a condominium or a house and lot is what are your needs today and how can real estate actually accomplish those needs? The future takes care of itself. Okay, now after you've sorted out your internal objectives and you've sorted out your budget, the next thing you do for me to make things easier is to choose a reputable developer. I think that in this industry where products are paid over the long term, the integrity, the effectivity, and the good name of the developer actually matters a lot in solving most of the issues with regards to property acquisition or buying a house and lot. So I think that one of the major considerations would be your choice of the developer. And then having chosen the developer, you look at his inventory and find out what locations is he present in.
Already considering putting some of their money in real estate. special tip for them? Like right now na nagayon pala sila ng money?
Yes, one of the things that we have discovered when we do our analytics from our demographic data is that a lot of our buyers are young. Today, I have at least 18% of my sales directly attributable to BPO workers, and these workers tend to be young. They tend to be single. I remember when I was about that age, ages between 25 to 35 years old, buying property was the last thing I had on my mind. And one of the reasons was there was no product at that time where my salary could actually afford me to actually put a down payment and to pay a monthly amortization on a house and lot. So today, the situation is so much different. And you have a lot of young people who are actually more financially aware and financially literate. And so my message to them is, yes, as soon as you have the capability and the decision, actually, to buy real estate property, please proceed to do so. One of the demographics they say about millennials is that they like to spend so much on consumption. Okay, the thing about consumption is that it makes you invest very little. And therefore, when the millennials actually think of buying assets and buying real estate property, then they're on the right track. So that at the end of a certain age period, they would have accumulated enough assets to actually lead a decent and a wonderful life going forward.
Christmas is coming up, so this is a special gift for those who are just receiving their 13th month pay. Because a lot of Filipinos are. Tell us what's smart and what's not, in your opinion.
So Christmas is coming, and what's smart is to actually spend some of your money for investment. Spend some of it for the family, and spend some of it for yourself. What's not smart is spending everything and borrowing on top of that, so that when January next year comes, you're actually worried about paying debts more than moving forward and buying assets.